Black Panther.
So fire. I don't need to watch any more trailers. You don't need to sell me on it. I'm in.
Yeah, stop dropping trailers and featurettes.
I don't need new anything. You have my money.
Yeah, save that extra $50 million. Yeah, just, you don't need to spend it.
We're going.
You know what's funny? Like, a movie like Black Panther probably has one of the biggest marketing budgets for the year, and it really is the one that needs the least.
The least.
Yes.
Like,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
the Marvel
yeah.
movies have
yeah.
the highest ones, and they really, like, no, just release
and
one trailer
this one
on YouTube.
Above all.
Yeah.
A black yeah. superhero, the Black Panther character, how this character was introduced in this universe.
Right. We're ready.
Fucking
yeah.
come on.
Yeah.
Like,
now I wonder if we'll get introduced to a new superhero in this one that'll have a movie coming out next year. Like, it seems to be kind of the pattern.
Ah.
Because that's kind of how they've been introducing.
I don't give a shit. I just I'm going to see this movie, and I'm ready for the Black Panther sequel.
Yes,
yeah.
it's coming.
Yeah.
Well, you'll get him in Infinity War. Yeah. He's definitely. Yeah. You could see there's some fighting in Wakanda going on in Infinity War. You know, might be over the vibranium. You never know.
I don't know. Spoiler alert.
Yeah. So the next movie is Early Man. This is a another movie from Aardman Studios. This is a UK studio that does Wallace and Gromit, and they've done Curse of the Were-Rabbit. And these movies, cool. I like their movies. They're really cool, and they're stop motion animation. It's a mm-hmm. dying art form. They never do well in this country. Like you yeah. know, they never do that well. But they're worth your time. They're definitely worth seeing because they're always something different or inventive in them. Like Chicken Run was another one that they did. So I think Early Man will be a fun movie.
If you have already seen Black Panther.
Yes, and you're looking for another movie to see.
And you just don't want to leave the multiplex.
Yeah.
Slide on into Early Man.
Yeah. And the next movie is Samson. This movie, I think all the investors are gearing for a write-down. So,
this is the end of the tax write-off?
Yeah. There is no way this movie is going to do well at all. First of all, there's no interest for it. Second of all,
what
you're
is it
releasing
about?
It. It's the biblical character, Samson, who was Samson and Delilah. The
hair guy? Is this the one with the
hair? It's the hair guy. Yeah. But you also, you have its period piece, big, sweeping, epic, and, you know, all this.
This movie's going to lose
so much
money.
It costs millions and millions of dollars that is going to make next to nothing, at least in this country. Like, you know, sometimes these movies do well overseas, but, you know, coming up against Black Panther and even Early Men, if you have kids, you're going to take them to, younger kids, you're going to take them to see that. There's no one going to go see Samson. The only way Samson's going to get any ticket sales is if somebody goes to the multiplex and both Black Panther and Early Man are sold out. Yeah.
Like,
well, we got to
see
something.
Multiple showings.
Yeah, yeah. All right, we got to see something. I already paid the sitter. We're not going home. We got to see something.
We don't know how to buy tickets in advance.
Yes.
And the theater doesn't have that.
Well, maybe I'll recommend 15 to 17 over Samson. If you need to see something.
Yeah.
I think you're right. I really
think. And 50 Shades is too naughty.
I think the venture capitalist money that put into this,
yeah.
the studio went, we need a $50 million loss so that we don't have to pay taxes.
Right.
Yeah.
Having watched all the money in the world and that's all he did was, that's why J. Paul Getty bought all the art was so he didn't have to pay taxes.
And we already made King Arthur last year. So, so we need another one to fill that slot.
Oh.
And get me Jude Law.
Give me.
So,
all right.
So good luck, investors.
And we will do a
Samson.
Black Panther spoiler up.
Yes, and a Samson spoiler up. I want to announce this. This is really exciting because he just confirmed today. We are actually going to have as a guest on the Black Panther spoiler app, Todd Perry, who was one of the people who did the visual effects for the film.
Oh,
so
awesome.
We're going to have some really cool stories.
And in honor of Samson, we're going to cut Todd Perry's hair. During
to see if he loses his CG power.
He won't have VFX power if we cut his hair, which we all know is true.
Yeah.
I shot first.